on the pages of the World Wrestling Federation magazine. Here's Update. Hi again, everyone. Gene Okerlin reminding you we're now just weeks away from WrestleMania 6 at Sky Dome in Toronto, the ultimate challenge. And you could be there for the action in person by calling 416-872-1111 to order your tickets by phone. Recently, we watched as the Intercontinental Champion, the Ultimate Warrior, squared off against Canadian strongman Dino Bravo. Now, after pinning Bravo, the Warrior was apparently shaken up after Earthquake stepped, or should I say stomped, into the ring. When who should appear but the World Wrestling Federation Champion, Hulk Hogan. Let's go to that footage.
Warrior hitting the ropes again, Bravo, and his big shoulder block. What a tackle that was! Off the rope, up, down, 1, 2, 3, got it. Oh, I don't believe it. Wait a minute.
Oh, no.
But the Earthquake got the Warrior.
Oh, no.
It's time for an insurance claim, McMahon. It's time for collision policy to take place. Double team effort on the Warrior. The Earthquake and Bravo, you talk about sore losers. Oh, but look at this. Warrior clotheslines the Big Man. Quake's gonna set him up. Here he goes. Oh, 150 some odd pounds. Did you feel those tremors, McMahon?
Indeed.
That was about 5.4 on the Richter scale.
And an elbow to the chest.
I got that one at 6.1.
Oh, no.
He's going for the big one, I think.
Earthquake. Setting up.
This is gonna do it. There's not gonna be any WrestleMania. Not after this.
Wait a minute. Hulk Hogan in the ring.
What? The Hulk is standing between the Earthquake and the Ultimate Warrior.
Pulling it right in.
I don't believe this. Hogan see the limelight enough?
What do you mean?
You heard me. I mean, he has to come out now and steal the thunder of the Ultimate Warrior.
That's not it at all. I don't think so.
Well, there's a heat discussion going on right now.
Oh, my. Wait a minute.
They're going to go at it. There's not going to be any WrestleMania. They're going to go at it right now.
Oh, boy.
Okay, we now know what happened, but why it happened is still a mystery. To shed some light on that question, let's hear from World Wrestling Federation Champion Hulk Hogan and the Ultimate Warrior.
You know something, Hulkamaniacs? In the last couple weeks, we've almost had a close encounter of the ultimate kind, man. The Warrior's been in my face, and I've been back in his. We could have already had WrestleMania over with by now. But the big dude upstairs is watching, man. He knows it's more important than just the WWF title, man. The Warrior, in his eyes, I can see that he's powerful. I can see that the energy is so wild that even he himself hasn't harnessed it, man, that he's looking for direction. But on the other hand, Warrior, being the WWF champion is a 24-hour-a-day job. You've got obligations and commitments around every corner, brother. And I was chosen, brother, by the Hulkamaniacs to lead the three demands of prayers, the vitamins, and the training, man. And the thing that worries me most about you, Warrior, if I was to slip on Godzilla's banana peel or some act of nature was to strike me down at WrestleMania, would you just run off into the darkness with the masses behind you and fall off the end of the earth, brother? The role I've taken, the direction the Hulkamaniacs have, is positive, it's straight and narrow, it's cut and dry, brother. And Warrior, the fact that you haven't harnessed the energy, the fact that you don't know which way the Warriors will go, scares me to death. I believe in my heart and in my soul, the powers of the Warriors and the powers of the Maniacs will collide, and we might even self-destruct each other, brother. But one thing is for sure, man. I can't let you run over Hulkamania. We've been rolling too long. Hulkamania's gonna live forever, and the direction will carry on long after we're dead and gone, brother. I would roll over in my grave if something happens that you turned out to be on the wrong side of the fence. So it's more than a title. It's a lifestyle. It's a belief. It's the three commandments, and come WrestleMania Ultimate Warrior, I'm gonna make you the ultimate Hulkamaniac. What you gonna do when the largest arms in the world run wild on you?
Going back to the homeland in search of talent.
Yeah, well, what
he doing with the powers of pain?
That's interesting, you know. I just wonder, could there be a conflict of interest there, McMahon?
Nah, when you think about Fuji, you know Fuji could handle both teams equally as well.
I don't believe so. There would be an obvious conflict of interest. Which tag team would he push? Which one would he spend the most time with? We spoke with Mr. Fuji a bit earlier on. Here's what he had to say.
Master Fuji, very, very happy. Have Ichiban, number one tag team from Japan called Orient Express. And we have lots of devious ideas for you.
Mr. Fuji, you're finding a little humor there somewhere.
Let me ask you something, McMahon.
Yeah?
Would you buy a car from Mr. Fuji?
No, I don't believe so. No.
You
not a new one, not a used one, no. I don't know that I would take one if he said it was for free.
You figure there might be strings attached?
Yeah, just a few.
A couple.
Yeah. Tanaka, hammering away. By the way, Jesse, I thought you looked rather ridiculous considering your commentary over the last several years concerning Hulk Hogan. To see you embrace Hulk Hogan, to wrap yourself up with all that Hulkamania garb when you are so insincere. I mean, it's one thing if you would mean it and you were a true Hulkamaniac, but you are so insincere, how could you possibly wrap yourself up in that this week and then say, well, I'm leaning a little bit toward Hulk in the main event? But then again, you reserve the right to change your mind.
Wait a minute, McMahon. You asked for a prediction.
Yeah.
You opened your mouth and started it all. I gave you the way I'm feeling right now. My gut feeling at this moment, I'm leaning towards Hogan to win it.
Ooh, look at that maneuver, would you, my son?
There's been many times I haven't leaned towards Hogan, and he has won it.
Indeed. One, two, and make it three. Yes, sir.
Beautiful bridge right there by Tanaka. Excellent wrestling move.
Tanaka and Sato. Thumbs down from the ringside area.
The Orient Express.
Mr. Fuji and his Orient Express. We take you down to the replay.
Beautiful back crusher kick. Wham! By Sato right there. Did you see that? He put it right on the side of the head. And a beautiful suplex into a bridge. Excellent amateur pinning combination right there. Good wrestling.
And now, let's take you to Jake the Snake.
$1 million man, you stood up so proud and you told me, if you want that $1 million belt, Jake the Snake Roberts, you got to come and get it. And that's exactly what I did. And you know something, brother? Since I've had it, I've kept it in a safe place. right here, man. And if you want it, you got to come and get it. But here's the thing. You got to think about something. Am I the kind of man that you trust? I mean, you could reach your hand in there, Virgil. And you might not find Damien. You might find this fella.
Or it could be this, Eastern Diamondback Rattler. I mean, you never know where they're going to show up, now, do you?
Then again, it could be Lucifer. That's Damien's big brother, and, he's never been nice when he's, shedding.
Or it could be this, cuckoo viper. Something to think about.
Or it could be this.
Or it could be this.
Trust me. Come on.
Your favorite part of telecast, Jesse.
I always lean forward to the front of my seat.
Thank you.
something big was going on. And when I heard that voice that sounded like rolling thunder, when it boomed out his warning, when it boomed out his challenge to meet and do battle with the mighty Hercules in WrestleMania 6, I knew that this would be my biggest test. I knew that this would be my biggest challenge. I knew that I would have to muster every ounce of energy and all the strength that I have to even survive a match such as this.
Well, you know, Brother Hercules, if indeed it is very doubtful that you survive an earthquake, everyone knows that after the quake is an aftershock, and I doubt you could survive that.
Brother Love, you'd be surprised at what I can do. Jimmy Hart, earthquake, I accept your challenge. I accept your declaration of war. And when it's all said and done in WrestleMania 6 in the Toronto Sky Dome, when the walls start shaking and the earth starts quaking, one man will be standing tall with his hands held high in victory, and that will be the mighty Hercules. You will find out what it means, earthquake, that only the strong survive in WrestleMania.
That's exactly what the boss man is, a fraud. He says that he's out here enforcing justice, and then he comes and takes a man that's spreading love like that fine brother Love, and then puts a ball and chain on him. Well, see if your ball and chain will go around these ankles in WrestleMania 6. That big man's gonna get you.
Slick, don't worry about Brother Love. He broke the law, and he got what he deserved. What you better worry about is Akeem. Come WrestleMania, you're going to find out that them shackles are one size fits all. And Akeem, I'm going to make sure that you wear them.
Dino, we got one with one, baby. Hulk Hogan, right here next week. Hurry, Dino, hurry.
I've been waiting for this, Jimmy. Hulk Hogan, you're going to realize, once and for all, Hulk Hogan, why do you refer to me as the world's strongest man? I'm going to get you, Hogan. Next week, Hulkamaniacs, we've got to pass another test. There's another hurdle in front of us, man. Dino Bravo, the strongest man in the world, is going to try to handle Hulkamania. But the 24-inch pythons will put him down so fast, he won't believe his own eyes, brother. Ultimate Warrior, I hope you're watching, man, because the way I manhandle the strongest man in the world, Dino Bravo, is the same way I'm going to handle you at WrestleMania 6. What you going to do?
Hulk Hogan, you're meeting Dino Bravo right here next week. If I were you, I'd be concerned about making WrestleMania. Because remember, nobody survives an earthquake.
All right, please welcome my guest. He does my hair. Here comes Brutus the Barber Beefcake. Go there.
So he doesn't need his hair, huh?
He doesn't have much work to do, does he?
WrestleMania right around the corner, and in that big spectacular, you're going to be facing none other than Mr. Perfect.
Well, I am so happy, BG, to have this opportunity to take on Mr. Perfect in WrestleMania 6, brother, because I am pumped up and I am ready as I've ever been, BG, to get in WrestleMania and give somebody a haircut that they will never forget.
Recently, in front of a national television audience, I've got to say this, you gave his advisor, Mr. Perfect's advisor, the genius, the old flat top, that special cut.
Well, Gene, I didn't quite get finished with that haircut because a little interference, Mr. Perfect jumping on my back, sticking his nose where it didn't belong. Well, that's okay because you didn't bust me up quite enough there, Perfect. You didn't get the job done. That's your biggest mistake because now I'm coming right for you in WrestleMania 6. I've been in 5 WrestleManias, Perfect. I know what it's all about to step in there. And believe me, there will be no butterflies.
You know, I should point out one thing here in closing. Brutus the Barber Beefcake, on many an occasion, the genius is in the corner, and he has been known to interfere.
Well, me, Gene, I got a little plan, something I worked out especially for the genius, to take care of any and all outside interference. So I hope you come down, genius. I hope you're waiting at ringside. I hope you step in there, brother. I'm going to take care of you. And when I take care of Mr. Perfect, I might have both of them laying side by side. Me, I might have to go eeny, and meeny, and miny. Hey, Mo, you know, I just go crazy sometimes, BG. I might have to cut everybody in the building. You never know.
All right, Brutus the Barber Beefcake, Mr. Perfect in WrestleMania, any final comment?
Well, Mr. Perfect, just to end a perfect night, I won't be able to do anything but give you the perfect haircut. Yeah!
He's a cutting and shredding during WrestleMania 6. You better believe that.
From the pages of the World Wrestling Federation magazine, here's a thing.
All right, hi again, everyone. Last week, we saw the debut of Mr. Fuji's new tag team, the Orient Express. Now, that announcement posed a serious conflict of interest in that Mr. Fuji has been manager for the Powers of Pain. Standing by, hopefully, to shed a little light on it all, let's hear from Mr. Fuji, the Doctor of Style Slick, and the Warlord.
You know, Mr. Fuji, you drive a hard bargain, brother. I had to dig deep. Deep, I say, into my pocketbook to purchase the Warlord's contract. But it's cool, because now I own him. And look at the size of this man. And it was worth every penny of it. Yeah.
All right, on the heels of those revelations, standing by once again, Mr. Fuji, this time with Bobby the Brain Heenan and the Big Barbarian.
Mr. Fuji, very, very happy, making lots of American money.
And you think you're happy, Mr. Fuji? I have just secured the contract of the Barbarian. Now I control this monster, and a lot of people out there are going to be very, very unhappy. Are you happy?
Very happy!
Thank you, Mr. Fuji.
All right, obviously, these moves rival some of the big sports trades that we've seen over the past couple of years. This one looks like everybody is a winner. Later in the hour, I'm going to be back with the WrestleMania Report. With update, I'm Gene Okerlund.
Hulkamaniacs, when I said that WrestleMania 6 was more intense than all five WrestleManias put together, I meant it, brothers. Every workout that I train is more intense. The pressure on my back is more intense than ever before. And every minute that I try to sleep, my heart pounds like a drum. I feel Hulkamania's in danger right now, Hulkamaniacs. This is the ultimate test of all times. And when I get in danger, I go back to my roots. I go back to the instincts. That's why I went back to Gold's Gym, Venice Beach, California, the power pit. That's why I went to the magic mirror, and I said, mirror, mirror on the wall, is the ultimate warrior the one that's going to make the Hulkster rise and fall? Usually I get a clear-cut answer, Hulkamaniacs. But this time, the magic mirror looked at me and said, Hulkster, you understand the natural balance of nature. You understand the food chain. You'll know if it happens. You'll know when it comes. All of a sudden, Hulkamaniacs, I started getting worried. The mirror faded out. There were no more answers. That's when I realized that WrestleMania 6 was the most important day for the rest of our lives because it will predict the future. Ultimate Warrior, if you're that little teeny Hulkamaniac that has trained and said his prayers and eaten his vitamins and finally rose to the number one contender position, I don't recognize you, brother. Maybe that's why you wore the war paint. Maybe that's why you cover your face so I won't know who you are. But as we get into WrestleMania 6 and you feel the power of the largest arms in the world, as I wipe that war paint off your face, Ultimate Warrior, if I realize that you are the new chosen one, I have an obligation to my Hulkamaniacs to fight with everything in my heart. My heart is strong like a lion. My arms are like the redwood trees in the forest. I have no flaws. My thoughts, my mind, my soul is pure.
But Ultimate Warrior, it has been written, it has been said, and it shall be done in WrestleMania 6. And if I find out that you're the one that has to walk for an eternity in my shoes, brother, let it be. But you got to prove to me by beating me and all my Hulkamaniacs that you are the Ultimate Hulkamaniac. And if you're not, what's that gonna do when the largest arms in the world run wild on you? I hope again. Have a question to answer. As you, Hulk Hogan, travel to WrestleMania by conventional means, the normals you travel with experience malfunctions. As you realize, all that is left is total self-destruction. Do you, Hulk Hogan, show self-pity? Do you, Hulk Hogan, try to reason why? Do you, Hulk Hogan, try and comfort the normals that have even more fear than you? Or do you, Hulk Hogan, kick the doors out? Kick the cockpit door down. Take the two pilots that have already made the sacrifice so that you can face this challenge. Dispose of them, Hulk Hogan. Assume the controls, Hulk Hogan. Shove that control into a nosedive, Hulk Hogan. Push yourself to total self-destruction. As you realize, Hulk Hogan, you are about to enter a world close to parts unknown. Oh, smell it, warriors. Do you, Hulk Hogan, look for a place to hide? Or do you, Hulk Hogan, face that challenge that may be more powerful than even you are, Hulk Hogan? You, Hulk Hogan, must self-destruct so that you will know, Hulk Hogan, who is the chosen one. For Hulk Hogan, I am not the chosen one that you speak. I am not. I, Hulk Hogan, am the only one.
something, baby. The times are changing. And that lovely wall in Berlin is crumbling down. And the Heart Foundation are going to send the Bolsheviks right through the roof of the Sky Dome, baby. Something, brother, love. Let's get our priorities straight here. The Heart Foundation, first and foremost, wants to win back the World Heavyweight Tag Team Championship belt. And the only way that we can do that is to issue a challenge right here and now to the winner of the match between the Colossal Connection and the Demolition. Wow. We want the winner of that one, brother love.
Oh, brothers, indeed. Do you really think for one moment that you really want to step in the ring with the likes of 7'4", 500-pound Andre the Giant and Haku, the Colossal Connection, what they would teach you what destruction is all about?
Well, Andre the Giant is a very, very dangerous opponent. And Haku is one mean fighting machine. We all know what the brain's thinking about, but wouldn't it be unfortunate if someone were to have a coronary heart attack?
Well, you know what would be unfortunate is if Demolition perhaps maybe squeezed by the Colossal Connection and won those belts. But if they did, would you really want to step in the ring with two men?
Let me tell you something, brother love. We know that the Demolition are big and bad and powerful, and that they've just about demolished every tag team in the WWF. But let's get something straight. The Heart Foundation's still here. We're still standing, and they haven't demolished us yet. And until they do, they better put up or shut up.
But first, you have to get through the
this week.
Dan, you forgive me.
Hogan. Those are flagrant fans. Oh, look at that. Wide in mind to Jimmy Hart. And he's from behind Butler attacking her.
Ladies and gentlemen, one of the classics. Mr. Piper, I would have to say that indeed you are two of the classic brawlers in the World Wrestling Federation.
No! I come from Scotland. I come from Glasgow. Took a long time for them people in Glasgow to be proud of me. I hear Bad News Brown. He talking about Harlem, how he comes from Harlem and how he's proud to be from Harlem. So I say, Fuji. It's what's inside you. He making this big issue. Ain't it, man? It's what's inside you. So, if I'm going to brawl in WrestleMania 6, and I have been in a few WrestleManias, if I'm going to brawl with this guy, you got to figure out where he's coming from. I asked Sapphire about him, and they say, bad news, Brown, he nothing but a bully.
Well, you know what you gotta have to be a bully? Just gotta have a little bull inside you. And this boy got plenty of bull inside him, man. Saw him walking around with his head bald.
Your head's bald. You shaved your head bald. What's wrong? We're not getting enough attention,
He's
my baby, why?
He's not a natural bald.
He's not a natural bald. No, not for that. Then he has the nurse, so what do we know about him? We've gotta get into the man. We know the man first of all because Sapphire said so. He's plainly a jerk. Now the guy says, Roddy Piper, he ain't nothing but a spineless cockroach.
Let's think about that. Wait a second. Let's think about that now. There ain't no cockroach in the world that's got a spine in it. So now we know two things about him. Not only is he a jerk, he's stupid. Huh?
Truly tough, there ain't no doubt about that. The guy is tough. They put me, boys and girls, I'm standing up here, I'm half black, I'm half white, I'm in a dress. Ain't I crazy enough to get the job done?
For a big honey dash.
Big taste, honeycomb, big taste. Honeycomb,
big, yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's not small.
No. Honeycomb's got big, 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 big crust for a big, big bite.
Honeycomb cereal, part of this big, complete breakfast.
Honeycomb's big, big bite, yeah!
Contest schedule for one fall. Currently in the ring at a total combined weight of 547 pounds, here are the Brooklyn Brawler and his partner, Black Butch.
Well, what an odd couple, Lord Albert Hayes. You got a big man from Texas and a guy from Brooklyn.
Two absolute extremes there. You're right, Tony. I wonder how they'll get along together as a team. Difficult to imagine.
Their opponents, two very strong, powerful individuals, and also you can throw in Quick, Paul Roma, and the Mighty Hercules, and this has the makings, Lord Albert Hayes, of a great tag team match.
Yes, it does indeed. Although all these pairings here are absolutely new to each other, I would imagine that Hercules and Paul Roma will form together more as a team than their opposition, Black Buck and the Brooklyn Brawler.
Some great strength in that corner. As you saw momentarily, Hercules and Paul Roma. Hercules trying to get his partner psyched up for this match. Paul Roma and the Brooklyn Brawler are no strangers. Brawler wants to keep that cigar and that hat on. He better get rid of it, or I would think Paul Roma would... Oh, right in the face! Slapped him with that hat and nails him with the right hand. So the Brawler now bites him on the forehead. And the Brawler going to work quickly on Paul Roma. Head of steam on the ropes. Roma! Oh, great dropkick. Oh, Paul Roma is such a remarkable athlete. And he comes up with a standing side headlock.
And whatever advantage the Brooklyn Brawler had in the beginning by taking him by surprise, Paul Roma has recaptured the authority of this match.
He has Black Bart. Snaps them both over. And now sends the Brawler out. Bart out. Hercules joins the ruckus. And he's working on Bart. Meanwhile, Roma working on the Brawler. And all four men are in.
And it certainly didn't take long for Hercules to come into the ring. He just can't stand being...
at that. Nice double team power slam. And the Brawler and Bart take the low road. They look pretty good as a team.
They certainly do. And obviously very, very pleased there. Somewhat elated with his partner's performance, Hercules. A broad smile on his face. And at this juncture, both Paul and Hercules looking very confident.
Remind the fans of the Ultimate Challenge Special on Sunday night, March 25th at 7 o'clock. Match is signed already. The Macho King will face Dusty Rhodes one-on-one that night. The Red Rooster against the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase, the Big Boss Man to take on Boris Zukov. And that's all exclusively right here on the USA Network.
Great matches you've just spoke about there, Tony. Bossman and Zukov, that should be just an incredible match. Bossman doing so well. Zukov, a big, big rush.
Of course, that Ultimate Challenge Special, just a prelude of the Ultimate Challenge, WrestleMania 6, Sunday afternoon, April 1st at 4 o'clock. Don't forget there that Hercules has his hands full against the Earthquake. And right now, Bart has his hands full with the boots of Hercules. Stomping on the hands. And of the eyes goes Black Bart. Down to the ropes. Reversal. Down goes Herc. Showing some great agility there. And the elbow on target. And down goes the Brawler also. Well, he walked right into that, didn't he?
He did indeed. Hercules very, very quick today. He's really moving with a lot of alacrity. And now this team of the Brooklyn Brawler, Black Bart, they cannot get their work together. They can't do it as a team.
Did you say he was moving with a lot of alacrity?
Yeah, alacrity, yes.
Alacrity?
Yeah, something like that. Well, you hit me with prelude a little while ago. I thought I'd come back with a word, Tony.
Okay. Outside of the ring, the Brawler and Black Bart. What do you think Hercules can do against the Earthquake in WrestleMania?
I would imagine a lot, quite honestly. He is one of the most powerful men that has ever appeared in the World Wrestling Federation. And we know the Earthquake has size and speed for a man of his size. And he has obviously a lot of strength to go with that. But Hercules is a very, very powerful man indeed.
Paul Romo, the double axe and the blow down on Black Bart. Bart basically in no man's land. It's Hercules and Romo. Doing a nice job of tagging in and out. Roma, you don't see much of that.
No, it went just a little awry there for Roma. He almost pulled off a very, very complicated maneuver there. But Black Bart is a big, cumbersome fellow, and that took a lot of doing.
Roma, Bart, double teaming. Roma and Hercules double teaming Bart, that is, double elbow. Bart goes back down to the mat. Again. Bart's headed up.
I think he has. They've been quite ineffectual so far against the pairing of Roma and Hercules.
Roma with a block. He sends Bart over and a great hip toss. Paul Roma flying down. Oh, little flying head scissors. Too close. And the only thing Bart needed to do was drop down to his knees and enable the Brawler to get the blow in.
Indeed, Roma was trying to perform another complicated maneuver, very similar to the first one that he pulled off, but his timing, or his geography, really was a little off there. He didn't realize he was so close to danger in the corner of the Brooklyn Brawler. And now distraction by Hercules is enabling the Brooklyn Brawler to even heap more damage upon Paul Roma.
Roma in trouble, and the fans here trying to get behind the team of Roma and Hercules. But Roma in trouble as Bart uses the tag rope. Hercules not helping matters at all, getting the attention of the referee, enabling the double team on the other side.
Well, Hercules does have a fiery temper, and sometimes he's inclined to let that smolder too much inside, and it forces him into the ring. And he's got to learn in tag team matches, you cannot do that. You've got to stay up.
A one count, Roma quickly out of it. The Brawler now with the reverse chin lock.
Brawler looking at the referee there, and I believe saying, I'm confident. complimentary things to the referee as well.
I believe that's what was happening also.
And that'll get him thrown out if he's not careful.
Over the top. The brawler goes down to the sunset flip. But from behind, Black Bart. With a save that time, nicely done also. This could enable, once again, a double team on this side. Hercules is ushered back out. Look at that! Just a dive right over top of the potential clothesline. A tag and a double clothesline. One hurt. And again! Roma really set that up nicely. Going over top of that double clothesline. And now Hercules sends the brawler down. And he's having to work on both men.
And I believe he's really enjoying himself at this juncture. He's done tremendously well against these two. And once again, this team of Hercules and Roma have established their authority.
Watch out, double team here. Sandy Paul over the catapult out to the center of the ring and a three count. And wow, maybe for the first time, but it was great for these two.
Just a tremendous victory there for Paul Roma and Hercules. Let us see how they pull this one out of the bag. Sometime before, here was this attempt at a clothesline by Black Bart and the Brooklyn Brawler, but Roma just dived completely over the top of this, and this left this situation for Hercules, who was quick to take advantage of it. A double clothesline there, and then Bart and the Brooklyn Brawler got up at the same time and suffered the same fate again. Tremendous stuff here by Hercules.
And then the catapult. And so, for maybe the first time together, Paul Roma and the mighty Hercules look great. Right here on Primetime Wrestling, let's go back to Gorilla Monsoon and Bobby the Brain Eden.
Ian, you're playing my game. It's my game.
Cliche, we play by my rules. Going out
yes,
there, I am
you're
not.
You're going out
no,
there.
No. So you don't understand.
If I
am
to
not
carry you
sensational
out there,
I think I've been a pretty good
Ian,
sport about
get
that.
Get up here.
Good. I feel
Ian,
like a cast member. I just don't know which role.
Yes.
A very cheap date the night after.
This is what a real Ian Mooney looks like, folks.
Sensational Queen Sherry, will you make me a small promise here?
What
let's make
that,
it a
Ian?
Big promise.
What, Ian?
Let's stick to wrestling. No more game shows.
I don't like
the prizes.
Well, what's if so I, if different than what you've got in your closet?
Can we talk about WrestleMania, perhaps, get off the subject here?
Yeah, let's have it.
Folks, no matter what you have to do, do not miss WrestleMania 6. I know it's a little tough to take me as being credible, but it's going to be some event. No more game shows,
no
okay?
No more games. I just got one thing to say to you, Ian. Honey, if you're going to be a queen, be a good one. See you next
that's
week.
That's very funny. Sensational Queen Sherry,
let me tell you something, Hulkamaniacs. Now that I've had one more week to think about this thing, I'm glad we took on the so-called strongest man in the world, Dino Bravo. It was just one more chance for us to prove that the Pythons are the strongest and the largest, and that Hulkamania is the most powerful force in the WWF. But also, I had a chance to think about the darkness, about the warrior, that the fact that when the darkness prevails, there'll be static and there won't be a clear picture. You know, when I had Dino Bravo on his back, I was cheap-shotted by the Earthquake Brothers. He tried to squash me like a grape, the life and breath almost out of my body. And then as I was regenerating myself, as I was stealing the energy from all my little holsters, the warrior hit the ring. Was it the natural food chain? Did he feel that I was wounded, that he could stalk this prey and make the kill? Or was it like what my little holster said? He's just trying to protect you, man. He's not the enemy. I don't believe either one. I don't know what his mission is, but I know one thing, Hulkamaniacs. It was like a total eclipse of the sun. It was like the moon passed between the sun and the earth. I felt the darkness, and in the arena, there was a cold hush. And all of a sudden, I realized the Hulkamaniacs didn't like the feeling. Hulk Hogan didn't like the feeling. We live in the sun. We're positive with the training, the prayers, and the vitamins, and the darkness is not for us. But Ultimate Warrior, just like the moon and the sun and the earth, we're all as one. We're an energy, brother. The only thing different now is we're divided on each side of the fence. The energy of the warrior versus the energy of Hulkamania, brother. And just like the sun, the moon, and the earth, we're all together. And ashes to ashes, dust to dust. At the end of WrestleMania, it'll be the Hulkster and God they still trust.
is this warrior, you, and only you understand. There can be no more fear. But I must speak, warriors. I must speak to you. For us to fulfill our destiny. For us to repay the ones that did make the sacrifice. We must protect Hulk Hogan. Command! Drop from the sky dome some 5 or 6 miles above the ring and sacrifice all they have. For them, Hulk Hogan, I must protect you from your own fears. I, yes, warriors, I understand. Have any reasoning, but we live for no reasoning. So accept what I must do, for in the end, he knows. Hulk Hogan already knows, warriors. He knows that we, that I, the ultimate warrior, can protect you from natural disasters. Normal disasters. But I, Hulk Hogan, have no control over the warriors. Therefore, Hulk Hogan, I cannot protect you from the power of the ultimate warrior.
Hatred and
disgust for demolition. So it's simple. If you want it, you come and get it. And if you think you can get it, it belongs to you. Like I said before, we have a problem, and we're going to solve that problem at WrestleMania 6. I guarantee it.
It's only a small problem for me. Don't worry about it.
And very shortly in WrestleMania 6 from Toronto, please welcome at this time sensational Queen Sherry and the Macho King, Randy Savage. Mixed tag team action, Skydome the location, and they will face the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, and Sapphire. I'm waiting for them.
And the world is also growing. I wonder, you know, sensational Queen Sherry has been in the ring before as a wrestler.
Sensational Queen Sherry has got a special message for Sapphire for WrestleMania 6.
Sapphire, because of the humiliation that you have bestowed upon the Kingdom of the Madness, it is my royal duty as Queen of the Macho Kingdom to exile you.
Is scheduled for one fall. In the ring to my right, from Pacific Beach, California, weighing 226 pounds, Bob Ellen. And his opponent, accompanied by his new manager, Bobby the Brain Heenan, weighing 300 pounds.
I think that Bobby the Brain has really picked him up quite an athlete.
He has indeed. He's a great acquisition for anybody at all. But with the guidance of Bobby Heenan, he's going to make this man absolutely stupendous.
Going up against Bob Allen. We've known for quite a while the strength and the power of the Barbarian, but also the quickness. And now part of the Heenan family. And there's a great shoulder. Right out of the ropes.
Yes, the Barbarian has ability in abundance. He really is a fantastic wrestler. And what a proposition this is for young Bob Allen. Oh, gosh, just look at that.
The big foot. Let's listen in to Bobby the Brain talk about the Barbarian.
I've never enjoyed myself more watching my new find here rip his opponent apart piece by piece. Well, on WrestleMania 6, Santana, he's going to do his finest work.
The power of the Barbarian, of course, meeting Tito Santana during WrestleMania 6, and what a matchup that's going to be, Alfred.
It really will, because Santana is a veteran wrestler, a man of terrific ability and great speed. But just look at the Barbarian now. It doesn't look as if anything could stop this man. He is absolutely devastating.
The Barbarian to the top turnbuckle. Getting ready to take flight. My goodness, with a clothesline over halfway across the ring. And Kid Bob Allen, tremendous win. Let's get the official word.
Here is your winner, the Barbarian.
A really superb victory for Bobby Heenan's new acquisition. Let's look at some of the highlights. There was a tremendous boot to the face there. A great karate kick by the Barbarian. Most impressive in this outing against Bob Allen.
The Barbarian, who can take flight and, of course, has all the power. And Bobby the Brain Heenan's a happy man, and why not? Now let's go back to the primetime studios.
Hulk Hogan! All I have ever experienced is the darkness that you now look into. But Hulk Hogan, you see no reflections of yourself the way you used to be. And the warriors smell this, Hulk Hogan. For before the warriors stands the lion. Through that light, Hulk Hogan, is our path in reaching the ultimate destiny. I, Hulk Hogan, look at that light with no fear. While you, Hulk Hogan, look into the darkness only filled with fear. I, Hulk Hogan, must take you into my world, my darkness, where, Hulk Hogan, you can never return. But with the strength that you had, Hulk Hogan, I will take everyone to places you would never go. Those that stood with film over their eyes will now see clearly that you, Hulk Hogan, had no choice. You had to surrender to the power of the ultimate warrior! You know something, ultimate warrior? Me and all my Hulkamaniacs have had it right about up to here with all your Frankenstein talk, man. We're tired of hearing you grovel for words. We're tired of watching you search for thoughts, brother. And I'm tired of hearing you talk about injecting all of my Hulkamaniacs with the poison, brother, that'll turn them into the darkness and make them run from the light. Let me tell you something, Ultimate Warrior. January 23rd, 1984, in Madison Square Garden, brother, when I won the WWF Championship, I held up a banner that said, I fear no man or beast, brother. The only thing that wasn't on the banner, it was a ghost. And that's exactly what you're gonna be, Ultimate Warrior. After WrestleMania 6, brother, when you find out where the power lies of Hulkamania in the strongest arms in the world, the 24-inch pythons, you, along with all of your warriors that are reaching down 6 foot below, reaching up from the darkness, you will be placed alongside of all those warriors, Ultimate Warrior. Past, present, and future, the Hulkster is the greatest WWF champion there ever was and there ever will be. And after WrestleMania 6, I'm going to prove that to all those warriors that still believe in you. What you gonna do when the largest arms in the world and the power of Hulkamania destroy you?
Whoa! Contest is scheduled for one fall. Coming down the aisle.
You know what I want to know, McMahon?
What's that?
Is Goulet gonna have the words written on a sheet of paper?
What do you mean by that?
I don't want that guy embarrassing me at WrestleMania for getting the words for the anthem.
Recorded earlier.
I can't believe they get Robert Goulet to sing at WrestleMania. He's no singer.
Don't worry about that. He's just doing the opening.
Well, that's good because he can't follow the rhythm and blues anyway. And we're going to be debuting our new hit single.
That's right. He can never follow rhythm.
Now, you're no good.
All right, Jesse, come on out with it. Have you heard an advanced copy?
Well, let's just say I've heard a rough cut. But I don't like to make any decision on rough cut.
All right, man.
We will see and hear the finished product at WrestleMania.
It must be bad.
Oh, it's phenomenally good. I'll tell you what, we'll finally put Robert Goulet in retirement, which we're all hoping for.
Beautiful.
Valentine with a kick to the midsection there. Fall through the form I still can't get used to. Rick the Hammer with long, dark hair and playing the guitar. I hope I can get used to this real quick. Team action. Come on, Ralph.
Beautiful back suplex right there. There's a cover by Honky. Yeah. Excellent teamwork.
I don't think Robert Goulet has anything at all to worry about.
I do, Jesse. Look at here. We're going to get a little guitar duet here, McMahon.
Oh, no. We have to listen to this.
Turn the music on, all right.
But it's not. The Honky Tonk Man, choose to get on.
You got something, Matt. Was the earthquake in L.A. a couple weeks ago? Because there was a 5.5 I experienced out there.
The brother earthquake! It was not long ago! Right here on the brother left show that I had! Hercules out here! And he told me at WrestleMania it would be the end of the earthquake!
Hercules is a powerful man! But 6'6", 461 pounds! Nobody can survive the earthquake! And Hercules, you won't survive the earthquake! WrestleMania 6.
Well, Brother Earthquake, speaking of WrestleMania 6, will you give Brother Lama a prediction? Who do you predict to win the ultimate challenge between Hulk Hogan and the Ultimate Warrior?
Between those two, I predict a natural disaster!
Well, you know, Brother, this is
Sunday afternoon, April the 1st, 4 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. Remember, you got a spring ahead next Sunday. You can be part of history in the making. We are anticipating the largest audience ever in pay-per-view history for WrestleMania 6, the Ultimate Challenge. I strongly suggest you get on the horn right now, touch base with the good folks, and make arrangements to join us on a pay-per-view basis. Get set for the greatest wrestling spectacular in World Wrestling Federation history. The stars and the superstars are going to be part of this incredible extravaganza from Sky Dome in Toronto next Sunday afternoon at a 4 p.m. Eastern Daylight start. Don't delay another week, another day, another minute, another second. Call your cable company right now to enjoy this tremendous afternoon of all family sports entertainment from the World Wrestling Federation. Here is your compendium of events that are going to be taking place next Sunday afternoon. We've heard already about the Ultimate Challenge. World Wrestling Federation champion Hulk Hogan meeting the Intercontinental champion, the Ultimate Warrior. The battle lines drawn for that one. And for the first time ever in World Wrestling Federation history, a mixed bag with Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, and his partner Sapphire meeting the Macho King, Randy Savage, and sensational Queen Sherry. Let's hear from those folks.
Yeah, WrestleMania 6. First big gig ever. Yeah, in the history of the World Wrestling Federation. Yeah. And the Macho King, the sensational Queen, will prevail over Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, and Sapphire. Yeah. Bottom line, yeah.
Oh, yeah, I got my main lady ready. She's training and ready. No matter what you say,
Macho Man. No matter how you put it, WrestleMania, it's all coming down. Me and the Sapphire, go get on it, baby. We all ready, are you, Dallas?
I'm ready.
Come and get it.
All right, there you have point counterpoint from the participants in that mixed doubles tag as part of WrestleMania 6. The Big Boss Man is going to be facing in a one-on-one matchup his former tag team partner, the African Dream. Akeem, the Big and the Powerful are going to be out for WrestleMania 6 next Sunday afternoon. Earthquake at 469 pounds meets the power, the strength of the mighty Hercules. There is a tag team title defense. You're going to be seeing Demolition challenging the Colossal Connection, Andre the Giant and Hawk Hoop.
Bobby Heenan and Colossal Connection, you can say anything you want, but the bottom line is, when we leave the ring, you're going to be looking up to us, the new champs.
You know something? It's going to be the final countdown, the final chapter for Colossal Connection, but a new book, the Book of Success, written by Demolition.
All right, there's more next Sunday afternoon in WrestleMania 6, the Ultimate Challenge one-on-one action. It's Tito Santana against the Barbarian. Hacksaw Jim Duggan squares off against Canadian strongman Dino Bravo. Brutus the Barber Beefcake meets Mr. Perfect. Superfly Jimmy Snuka squares off against Ravishing Rick Rude. Coco Beware to meet the fashion model Rick Martel. In tag team action, the Hart Foundation, Bret the Hitman Hart and Jim the Anvil Neidhart, square off against the Bolsheviks, Nikolai Volkov and Boris Zhukov. Here's one for the $1 million belt. It's going to be Jake the Snake Roberts beating this man, Ted DiBiase.
What else do I have to do, Jake Roberts? I beat you, I embarrass you, I humiliate you, I put you in the hospital, and you come back and you steal my property, $1 million worth of gold and diamonds, my championship $1 million belt. And the WWF says I have to come back at WrestleMania, step in the ring, and beat you for something that already belongs to me. Well, if that's the way it's gotta be, that's the way it will be.
All right, more tag team action. The Orient Express will be facing the Rockers, Marty Jannetty, and Shawn Michaels. There's more in a musical vein. Rhythm and Blues, that's the Honky Tonk Band, and Greg the Hammer Valentine are going to be, for the first time ever, premiering their brand new hit, Honka 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 Honky Love. I can hardly wait for that one. And by the way, the stars and the superstars are going to be out. Yes, celebrities, singing O Canada, Robert Goulet, with an inside track on virtually everything that's going to be happening around WrestleMania 6, the Ultimate Challenge, this lady, Rona Barrett.
Just how macho is the Macho King? We'll find out from sensational Queen Sherry in my exclusive report at WrestleMania.
Heaven forbid Rona Barrett and Jesse the Body Ventura should huddle next week during the course of WrestleMania 6, the Ultimate Challenge. You talk about scoops. Who knows what could come out of that meeting? One of my all-time favorites will be a guest celebrity. Next week, next Sunday afternoon at WrestleMania 6, I'm talking about Steve Allen.
Hiya, folks. Steve Allen here. Listen, a viewer writes, "Dear Steve, I know that before you became a famous comedian and TV personality, you worked as a wrestling announcer. Well, with WrestleMania just around the corner, how would you rate the wrestling of your day with that of today? Signed, from one TV legend to another, Jesse Ventura." Well, Jesse, thanks to the WWF, the wrestling's come a long way. Thanks to you, however, the announcing still has quite a way to go. I rest my case. Get out of here.
I, for one, personally, am looking very much forward to working with the legendary Steve Allen. Folks, it just doesn't get any better than this. WrestleMania 6, the Ultimate Challenge. Live on pay-per-view next Sunday afternoon, April the 1st, 4 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. Spring ahead 1 hour. Eastern Daylight Time from Skydome in Toronto, Canada. Be there for a ringside seat in the comfort of your own home on your very own television set. Call your cable company and make those all-important arrangements. Simply request WrestleMania 6, the Ultimate Challenge. I guarantee you this is going to be the biggest pay-per-view special ever. And, of course, we'll see you from Skydome in Toronto Sunday afternoon, next Sunday afternoon, April the 1st. With your WrestleMania report, I'm Gene Okerlund.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're a week away from WrestleMania. Please welcome Sapphire and the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. Just a little over a week away, you're going to be part of history in the making. For the first time ever in World Wrestling Federation history, we're going to be seeing a mixed tag. It's going to be sensational Queen Sherry and the Macho King, Randy Savage, facing Sweet Sapphire and you, Dusty Rhodes.
Sunday afternoon. That's a big unknown. Yeah, you got that right. Good pun, McMahon.
I didn't mean it that way.
A big unknown.
I didn't mean it that way. Look at this. Elbow. Come on in, Sherry.
Oh, yeah, what? The Dream wants to fight Sherry now. That's tough, Dream.
No, from behind. Don't turn your back on the Macho King.
Yeah, now look at this.
Oh, she's in trouble. Sapphire. Look at that. And the Dream helps Sapphire to the outside. But there won't be any outside when we see the first ever World Wrestling Federation mixed tag team match next Sunday afternoon.
That's right. Old Sapphire's going to have to hang in there when it's her turn. Now, come on, McMahon.
What?
Can you honestly sit here and tell me that you believe that Sapphire is of the same athletic caliber as Sensational Sherry, Queen Sherry?
No, I can't say that she is, but I can't say that she isn't, because not much is known about Sapphire.
Yeah, but a lot is known about Queen Sherry.
That's true.
I mean, it would probably be a toss-up if she took on the American Dream.
Oh, yeah, sure.
Whoa, my! And the Macho King spilled heavily out to the floor. Now look at the guts on the part of Queen Sherry, standing right up there, facing down with the Dream.
Yeah, from behind. Oh, no, right into the post.
And I don't see Sapphire coming around to save her man.
I don't think her man needs saving at the moment. The Macho King going out.
You don't think so?
From
I think
the top
so.
Rope, the Macho King. Boom, right down into the Dream. We have a cover. Only a 2 count. Jesse, you are fully aware, are you not, of the rules in the first ever mixed tag team matchup at WrestleMania?
Refresh my memory, McMahon.
Well, obviously, when a male is in the ring, he must wrestle another male. His opponent, in this case, it'll be the Dream and the Macho King. At no time, according to the rule book, at no time will Savage be able to be in the ring with Sapphire or the Dream Dusty Rhodes in the ring with Sensational Sherry.
Well, look at that. There you go. Look at that. See how capable Sherry is? I'm telling you, she could wrestle the Dream. And you know, those rules, and I'm going to bring this up to President Jack Tunney, I find those rules very sexist in today's day and age.
Oh, come on.
Hey, women are equal, right? Right?
Of course they are. They're more than equal, but not when it comes to something like this.
Then if they want to play lumberjack, they should carry their end of the law. Right?
I'm not going to agree with you anymore on that. Sherry with who knows what she has in that purse into the back of the head of the Dream, and he knocked, well, he was knocked right down to the canvas. Ooh, hard right hand by the Macho King.
And now why isn't it that Sapphire is not helping her man out? I mean, it's obvious Rhodes is getting double-teamed by not only the Macho King, but look at that.
Look at that maneuver.
The Dream nails him. He's going to... Oh, he hit her.
He did not.
He struck a woman.
He
I can't
not.
Believe it.
He certainly did not.
I can't believe it.
From behind the Macho King.
To the rescue.
To the rescue.
Can you imagine that?
That witch, Sherry, you saw what she was doing to the Dream.
Dusty Rhodes hit her.
He did not hit her. Ooh, my with the knee. Worry around two. All we can get. Well, here's what? Telling what's going to happen.
Rhodes is going out after her again.
He is not. Unfortunately, the Macho King from high above. Down into the shoulder and neck area of the American Dream. Then everything's going to break loose on the count of two.
Yeah, totally, totally. I'm loving it. Look at Sherry getting involved.
What is she doing? She's distracting the official. That's what she's doing. The Macho King is going to go up and come crashing down with the bell.
And he rang Dusty's bell.
Oh, funny, funny, funny.
There it is.
About that, the Dream kicks out.
Well, I gotta say right there, Macho King should have gone for a better cover right there. He should have hooked the leg.
Savage. Just hammering a moment ago. And again, those left jabs. What's going on here? Dusty Rhodes has found the reserve from somewhere. Oh, and he caught the Macho King flush on the chin with that elbow. I don't think I've ever seen the Dream with so much resilience. He's been beaten from pillar to post. He was hammered with a bell, a steel bell, in the back of the head just moments ago. Maybe that was the problem. Macho hit him in the head. Oh, my. That'll do it. I don't care how tough you are. Good thumb to the eye will slow you down. The top rope. Oh, the Dream catches him, drives him back. And again, Sherry distracting. And look at her from behind. Whoa. And Sherry levels her. Now you tell me how she's going to hold her hand to the log up, McMahon. Sapphire back to her feet. Sapphire grabs the ankle again. Drop Sherry down. And Sapphire belts Sherry down. Okay, Jesse.
Yeah, from
you
behind.
Tell me.
From behind.
Oh, come on.
No.
Hit her, Mike. Don't you dare. Don't you dare. Ooh, look at this. Oh, yeah. The Dream. And this is just mild, McMahon, compared to what's going to happen next Sunday. Wow, I don't want to miss that one. The first ever mixed tag team match in World Wrestling Federation history. And we're getting a little sampling of it right here. Come on, ref. That's enough. That'll do it right there. That's a disqualification. Blatant disqualification. She's going too far. Sapphire. What a hit for her. Yanks her off. All four individuals going at it.
We got chaos all over the place now, McMahon.
And Sapphire. Back again.
And Rhodes is good. Look at this.
Back there. Get back in there. The Sapphire.
That is two times now that Rhodes has manhandled a woman.
Manhandled.
You heard me. He should be ashamed of himself. Where I come from, you don't treat women that way, McMahon.
Just where do you come from, Jesse? We know one thing. We're coming from the Sky Dome next Sunday afternoon. As we see the first ever World Wrestling Federation Mixed Tag Team matchup. And wow, I just can't imagine what is going to happen. This, a sampling of what we're going to see next Sunday. There is a very difficult... No! The Macho King better watch what he's doing now. He better save something for next Sunday.
Oh,
do it! Do it, Sapphire!
Is that ring reinforced?
Finally, the official's out. They want to get the Macho King out of there. He's caused enough problems for once. Who's that fat guy with glasses?
I don't know if the Macho King's going to boot him in the head in a minute if he don't get out of there.
Sherry and the Macho King being asked to go back to the dressing room area. Save it. Save it for next Sunday.
And you can believe me that they will.
The Macho King will be more determined than ever.
I told you before, there's the man, the only man in the world capable of taking on two heavyweight champions in one night.
So he has to take on, along with his tag team partner, Sensational Queen Sherry, two more heavyweights of a different kind, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, and Sweet Sapphire.
Boy, you got that right. Ha! Two more heavyweights. There's a heavyweight.
And it could very well be that the Macho King and Sensational Sherry have a new appreciation of polka dots.
Gentlemen, we're here tonight to witness the official signing of the main event for WrestleMania 6 to be held at Sky Dome in Toronto, Canada, next Sunday. This is the first in the history of the World Wrestling Federation. It will be title for title. However, you gentlemen and your attorneys have both gone over the contracts extensively. And, Mr. Hogan, are you prepared to sign at this time?
Yeah, I'll sign, Mr. President. You know, Ultimate Warrior, you don't realize what this means to me and all my Hulkamaniacs. That dark cloud, the darkness that you live in, once you sign, this is where you're going to remain. Because the positive light of the training, the prayers, and the vitamins will prove at WrestleMania 6 that Hulkamania is still the strongest force in the universe. Step into the darkness once again.
Warrior?
Hulk Hogan. What lies before us in the heavyweight championship of the world and the Intercontinental Championship of the World are nothing but normal representations of why there are followers and why there are leaders such as us. But you, Hulk Hogan, know as well as I do that they are only receptors for the powers that we have. Look into my eyes, Hulk Hogan! You see nothingness. You see no reasons for questions. You see no answers. For there is no reasoning in the thinking of the Ultimate Warrior. At WrestleMania 6, Hulk Hogan, I will take the powers of those that question. And I will take the powers of those that have no fear. As I take two and become one.
Sign.
Thank you. Thank you very much, gentlemen.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing
Jesse, where's your family going to be this Sunday afternoon?
Weighing 242
pounds. Where's my family?
Pounds.
I got a private box right at Sky Dome.
You do?
Absolutely.
How did you get that?
How did I get that?
And yeah,
I'm a star. What do you expect?
They treat you like that?
Certainly.
Of the South, Jimmy
Tater,
Hart.
The whole thing, McMahon.
From Vancouver, Tater.
Yep.
British Columbia,
dinner
Canada.
For 20.
Weighing
for 20. Black tie.
69 pounds.
Everyone's in black tie except you, of course.
Absolutely, I'm working.
Yeah,
take a look at this.
And wait till you see who's going to be up there in my private.
You mean you're bringing some of your Hollywood friends?
Well, let me put it this way. There'll be myself, the only male, and 19 females. That's a black tie dinner, Bonnie style.
I see.
It's going to be a who's who. And Rona Barrett ain't invited.
I guess not.
Earthquake! Little psych-out job here on Rugged Ronnie Garvin. Did it work?
I don't think so.
Ronnie Garvin's one guy who's too bullheaded to get psyched out.
He is bullheaded, isn't he?
He has to be to wear a haircut like that.
Like what?
Come on, McMahon.
That's a nice-looking haircut.
That went out with Bill Haley in the comics.
I didn't think you remembered Bill Haley in the comments.
I don't, but I read history.
Oh.
And look at the posing right there. There's a body beautiful.
No, nothing beautiful about that body at all. Nothing beautiful at the way he executes his earthquake either.
And Garvin's being smart. You know, he's trying to stay away, but look at, he's caught now.
Ooh, big right nice hand. Maneuver. He caught a nice maneuver. Headbutt by Rugged Ronnie Garvin.
And that's what Garvin's got to do.
Toes, yes.
That's what he's got to do. He's got to hit and run. Hit and run. Don't get caught.
Garvin, a converted southpaw.
Come on, Quake, baby. You got to take care of this yourself.
Well, you can bet that Earthquake has a little better appreciation, I think, for Rugged Ronnie Garvin at this moment than he did when he stepped into the ring to begin the match.
Well, Garvin's being smart. He's using his speed. He gives up a tremendous amount of size and strength. There, a nice go behind.
Oh, no,
but look at
not smart.
He can't even lock the hands. Look at that.
Wild elbow misses, and Garvin right there with a chop. However, if you're the mighty Hercules, Jesse, how do you handle an earthquake if you're the mighty Hercules? That matchup, of course, next Sunday at WrestleMania.
Well, Herc's got a problem because Herc's got an ego. And what I mean by that is Herc loves his strength, and he loves the title of being Hercules, so you know there's the mouth of the South giving instructions. You know that Hercules is going to match up power for power with this guy because of his ego. And I think that's the major mistake he's going to make. You're not going to see Hercules run and use quickness like Garvin tried to do. And I don't think Hercules dares match up strength just on sheer size of the earthquake.
Wait a minute, you just said that's what he was going to do because of his ego.
That's what he has to do and he will do. I'm not saying it's the smart thing to do.
Ooh, wow.
I didn't say it was the smart thing to do. I said that's what I believe will happen. Though. You know, Herc's not exactly a Rhodes Scholar.
No, I guess not. Oh, no. This man drops and he misses.
And that was a great move by Rugged Ronnie Garvin right there.
All right, now, you don't think Garvin really thought he had a chance of pinning the earthquake at that moment, but nonetheless, isn't there a reason, Jesse, to cover someone like that just for a pure psychological reason?
Well, not psychological either, McMahon. If the guy's stunned for that extra second, or if he's napping a little, or maybe he doesn't hear the first count.
Yeah.
You could get a quick win that way, and in Garvin's situation, he's got to go for anything he can. Anything.
Garvin, the veteran. Oh, my. Working to the facial area.
This is smart if you don't get caught.
From behind, and he doesn't get, and he drops the big man to his knees.
Well, now Garvin's accomplished a major thing right here. He's gotten the quake down to one knee. He's got
him. He's down.
Wow. Could this be upset? Not quite.
No. I'm not too sure that Garvin could use his leg lock against a man whose legs are this massive.
You know, you like to believe that David could take Goliath, but it's cases like this where I think that's all fiction.
Garvin to the buckle. Earthquake ahead of Steve and he misses. A cover. Get down on him. No. Got to his stomach immediately. Garvin going back up. High risk maneuver. Garvin from the top.
Uh-oh. He went to the well once too many.
Look at the look. Look at the look on Earthquake's face.
Look at the look on Garvin's face. That's the better one.
Whoa,
whoa. And I don't care, he's rugged, but I don't care how rugged you are. 400 and how many pounds? 68, 85?
I don't know, he's way up there. Is he gonna do it?
He's going to
the ropes. Earthquake coming down to the chest. And nobody gets up. Well, I'll tell you what, you could give Rugged Ronnie Garvin
the winner of this bout.
He for effort on that one.
Oh, absolutely. He gave it everything he had. Oh, here's the aftershock.
Oh, no.
Wham.
Get him off.
And I'll tell you, that could very well be the mighty Hercules next Sunday, McMahon.
He's going to do it again.
Position.
He's going to hit the rope. Garvin again.
And I got a feeling Rugged Ronnie Garvin has sustained some injuries after three of them.
Yeah, I would think so. I would think Garvin is obviously not going to get up. Oh, no. That's too bad. Oh, no. No, don't do that.
Let's go to replay and see how the earthquake caught Garvin. Garvin trying for the second time to come off the top rope. Gets caught by the earthquake. Beautiful power body slam. That, of course, knocking the wind out of Garvin. Setting up this move. The earthquake right there. And the 1-2-3 pinfall.
And there's a good look at the size of the girth of the earthquake.
Oh, and there's a look. And there's a good look at a stretcher. And apparently that's what awaits Rugged Ronnie Garvin. Not a pretty sight, McMahon.
No, I wouldn't think so. I must say, Rugged Ronnie Garvin is one of the more valiant wrestlers you'll ever find anywhere. He gives it 1,000%, and he gave the earthquake more than just a few anxious moments. But nonetheless, this is the result of earthquake crashing down into the chest. Possible busted sternum, maybe broken ribs. This man, Earthquake, will be a force to reckon with next Sunday.
The following
This should be some tag team matchup, Jesse.
Introducing in the ring, the tag team combination managed by Bobby the Brain Heenan. At a combined weight of
Why shouldn't he smile? He's got the champs. At the moment.
The World Wrestling Federation tag team champions, Andre the Giant, his partner, Haku, the Colossal Connection.
Oh, my, and look who's headed to meet him.
What was that?
You find some humor here, Jesse?
A little bit.
I mean, let me put it to you this way. Andre the Giant outweighs both of these two combined.
Well, that's true. However, these two individuals, The Rocker, Shawn Michaels, Marty Jannetty, could very well be the Giant Killers, Jesse.
Maybe, if you believe in fairy tales, McMahon.
Both teams have a match they were not going to soon forget, I don't believe, next Sunday afternoon.
Oh, no, look at this. And look at this. The Colossal Connection, the champs, not even waiting for the bell.
And Jannetty and Michaels, look at that maneuver. Double drop kick, and the Giant is down. He's locked in the ropes. How about that?
And it took a double team to do it. What do you mean,
eat
my
words, Jesse?
Why is it the referee stepping in and getting rid of these double teams? Only one man can be in the ring at a time.
Wait a minute. Why is the official helping Andre out over there? He's locked in the ropes. Andre locked in the ropes. Maybe he can get out now. Yes, finally.
And now we'll find out what the now we'll find out what the Rockers can do when it's one-on-one.
Haku with Shawn Michaels, a headbutt. Standing headlock. Marty Jannetty tagged in from behind.
Legal tag.
Yes, indeed. Clothesline misses. Oh, look at this.
Would you?
Haku. Oh, yeah. One, two.
All he gets is two. Not even the drop kick will keep big Haku down for a three.
Yank of the hair. Back up. Nice maneuver.
Well, that's what the Rockers have to do. They have to use speed. Now there's a problem. Now there's a big problem. A big problem. I mean, you're looking at, what, a 275-pound weight advantage to Andre the Giant here?
Something way off the scales like that.
Marty Jannetty must think he's, what, jacking the beanstalk right now?
I don't know.
Oh, forget it.
Ooh. Oh, no.
Oh, I felt that one all the way up here, McMahon.
Oh, no.
Like I said, they got a big, big problem.
Andre the Giant and Haku defending the tag team championship next Sunday at WrestleMania against Action Smash Demolition, former title holders. And the Rockers next Sunday are scheduled to face the Orient Express.
Well, that'll be a little more in the Rockers' style. That'll be a fast one, the Orient Express against the Rockers. What moves we all see in that matchup.
Legal tag, and Haku hits him with the elbow. Look at that maneuver. Nicely done. Double elbow.
Oh, but Jannetty got caught by Andre. He went to hit the ropes, and the big Giant nailed him. Look at that. There takes care of Shawn Michaels. And now we're going to see a double team the other way. Now, this is called a major mismatch here in the game.
Yeah, I guess so. Here comes Haku. Right in the kisser.
And I believe he knocked him out. He can get it right here if he wants it.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Look at Andre bringing Michaels into the ring. He's going to pin both of them.
Wait a minute. What's going on here? Action Smash coming in.
Now that, you know what this tells me right here? Demolition scared to death of them. They gotta come in and back jump them from behind.
Action Smash, sending Andre the Giant and Haku out of the ring.
Now you condone
There's a legal match going on in the ring right there. No reason for any interference. Just raising their hands like they won.
Come WrestleMania time. Come WrestleMania time. All is fair, Jesse, as you well know.
That's a week away.
Exactly. And this, perhaps the last impression that Andre the Giant and Haku will have of Demolition as they defend the tag team championship next Sunday afternoon.
Please welcome the big boss man.
And Akeem will be seeing him close. And personal. We're going to be reinforced for that one. And he's going to dish out some justice. WrestleMania 6. The big boss man gets his
Sunday afternoon, Boss Man, you're going to be facing the man who at one time was your tag team partner. I'm talking about the African Dream, Akeem, who certainly is no stranger to the cops.
And no stranger to breaking the law. You're big, you're bad, boy, but I want you to read something. Big Boss Man. It doesn't say little Boss Man. It doesn't say small Boss Man. It says Big Boss Man. And you come pushing on me like you pushed on everybody else. Slick, if you step out of line with me, boy, I'll tie your neck into a bristle knot, punk.
All right, get ready for the shootout this Sunday at WrestleMania with Akeem.
Hulk Hogan, with only a handful of sunrises and a handful of sunsets, the greatest battle that shall ever take place will be upon us. Two of the greatest warriors that commanded their greatest forces will face each other for that one last breath of combat. But during the phases of that battle, Hulk Hogan, you will see, as the paint leaves the skin, the covering of the Ultimate Warrior, you will realize this did not indicate that he was the one. This is the one that came to take me and what I drive for further than it has ever been. No, Hulk Hogan, you will see it in my eyes. Then, Hulk Hogan, you will know that I am then Hulk Hogan, as you surrender your strength, I, Hulk Hogan, will walk into those challenges ahead with the power of the two that has become one. You know something, Ultimate Warrior? The one thing that we both agree upon, dude, and the one thing that we have in common are the facts, brother, that you stated when you said there were only a few sunsets left, man, and there were only a few sunrises left, Ultimate Warrior. This Sunday afternoon at WrestleMania 6, brother, me and all my little Hulksters predict this will be the last sunset for the Ultimate Warrior, man. You know, physically, I'm ready for your challenge. The largest arms in the world, dude, can handle you at any time. Emotionally and morally, the support that I've got worldwide is unsurpassed at any energy level. the winding down in these last few hours, brother. Spiritually, I just had to make sure that I was reassured. That's why, dude, I went back to my roots, brother. Venice Beach, California. And as I hung on to the ape hangers, brother, of my Y-Glide Harley-Davidson, I turned towards the sands of Venice Beach, California. And as I rode through the sands, I headed for the Pacific Ocean. And as I hit the water on the Y-Glide, brother, I buried the tire. I buried the front fork until the Harley putted to a stop. And then on the solo seat, I leaned back and I looked up to my God in heaven. And as all your mythological gods ran for cover, I screamed, "What is the destiny of Hulkamania?" As my God looked down between my eyes, he said, "Hulkster, you were born to rule. Hulkamania will never die. Ultimate One." Once I heard that, brother, that's all I needed, brother, to carry me through these last few hours. So this Sunday afternoon, when the largest arms in the world are raised in victory, when the largest shadow ever covers Sky Dome, it's not a 747 coming in for a crash landing, brother. And when the single by and try puts you in the darkness, when you stand in the shadow at high noon of Hulkamania, only then will you realize that I am the strongest force in the universe. And as far as the darkness goes, brother, in the light of the training, the prayers, and the vitamins, it's like oil and water, brother. It'll never mix. My people will never follow you. But in the end, at WrestleMania 6, once I beat you right in the center of Sky Dome, you will then become the ultimate Hulkamaniac, and you will be on my side. And what you gonna do when the ultimate power of Hulkamania destroys you?
Oh, look at that. Thumbs down already, Jesse.
Thank you.
And he thanks him.
Rock him!
What
does
he do in the first place?
Will shatter the dream of Dusty Rose and Sapphire this Sunday at WrestleMania, New York! The Macho King Randy Savage and the sensational Queen Sherry!
Look at that outfit of the Macho King Randy Savage. Macho King always impresses me, man. I'm one of his biggest fans. I make no bones about that. Not a greater talent. You know, you should now proclaim him a great wrestler. What do you mean? I mean, after all, I'll tell you what brother loves, though.
American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, and Sapphire!
but the possibility of Little Sapphire in the ring with the Macho King. Run wild. Let the American dream, Dusty Rhodes, split and think. Possibilities with the whole world watching in the first mixed tag team match in the history of the World Wrestling Federation.
This is the